Hi viewer, I welcome you to Edim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through business studies, form 2, lesson number 15. The topic it is communication. I'm your tutor, Rosi Muthoni. Welcome. Let us look at the lesson objectives. Today we are going to look at the communication. We look at the meaning of communication and its importance. Then describe the lines of communication and the essentials of effective communication. Let's get started. Communication. Communication is the process of passing information from one person to another. Relaying of information from one person to another. So that is what we refer to it as communication. You cannot communicate if at all you are the one person and you are not passing any information. You must pass all information either from one person to another or from one person to the group or from the group to the one person. So there must be that passing of information. What are the importance of communication? One, giving and obtaining information. So that is one. Through communication, that is the time when we get the information. That is when we give out the information. What you expect, what I am expecting to do, I'd get it through communication. Number two, clarifying issues and points. A point where now you maybe you have just given out a memo and you want to clarify about it, you just use the communication in order to clarify an issue or a point. Enhancing public relations. Through communication, it assists people to relate together properly. And this is what is referred to as the public relations. Next, starting and influencing action. This is only done through communication. You start an action through communication and also influence that action to take place through communication. Improving customer service. Unless you get the feedback from the customers, you cannot improve their services. The services they are getting cannot be improved. So you must get information how your customers are being served, how they expect to be served, in order for you now to start improving the customer service. Next, giving instructions. This is the point where now you start giving instructions. In any organization, there are the instructions that are supposed to be followed. So in this case now, you get that process of giving out instruction. It is still communication. It can be through the memos. It can be through verbals. It can be through the phone calls. That is all communication. Next, confirming arrangement. When you want to get to know how the arrangement is supposed to be or the arrangement of something, you need to seek information from the people who are organizing that occasion, that business. So there is need for getting the confirmation of the arrangement through communication, only gotten or only received through communication. Next. Coordinating department of the firm. If at all there is no communication between one department and another, then there is nothing like coordination in any firm. Then, giving reassurance. We go to the lines of communication. This refers to the direction in which communication flows from the sender to the receiver. Lines of communication can either be vertical, horizontal, or diagonal. Let us have a look at them. Vertical communication. Vertical communication is a communication process where the senior and his or her juniors in the same organization communicate. Majorly divided into two. downward communication, that is from the senior to the juniors, and upward communication from the juniors to the seniors. Downward communication is the process where a person communicates to his or a genius. It can be used when training the juniors, evaluating performance, delegating duties, solving any problems facing the workers, inspiring and motivating the juniors. So that is the time when now the downward communication can be applied. Go to the upward communication. This is communication process where now a person communicates with his or a senior. It may be used when submitting report. A junior is submitting report to the senior. Number two, giving suggestions. Number three, submitting complaints. Activity. State how upward communication is done in any company. Number two, state how downward communication is done in a company. For reference, you can get the KLB 2011 Invent a Secondary Business Student Book 2, that edition. Or if at all you get to get us, you can get us through the SMS. You can also get us from the YouTube, from the Facebook, and also from Elimu. You can Twitter us to that. Stay tuned to Elimu TV. Thank you.